My name is Rolf Wachter. I'm a cardiology consultant in Göttingen in Germany.
Why is the detection of atrial fibrillation so difficult for clinicians? Why do you think that's the case?
Persistent and permanent atrial fibrillation you can easily find if you just write an ECG. A paroxysmal atrial fibrillation is a form of atrial fibrillation that comes and goes. So we need to monitor the heart rhythm for a longer time period, and that's the reason why it's so difficult to catch up paroxysmal atrial fibrillation.
What is AF burden and what does it mean in clinical practice?
AF burden means the time of the total time that a patient is in atrial fibrillation. We know that the AF burden sometimes correlates with the symptoms of the patient. We yet do not know whether the AF burden really has an impact on the prognosis of the patient. So we do not know whether patients who have a higher burden of atrial fibrillation have a higher risk of stroke compared to patients who do not have atrial fibrillation. It seems that the benchmark that the patient has to achieve, or to say a limit of atrial fibrillation, is very low, where the risk of stroke is already increased.
What are the benefits of early detection of atrial fibrillation?
In my personal opinion, I think if we want to reduce the burden of stroke in the society, the early detection of atrial fibrillation is probably one of the most cost-effective and most effective measures to reduce the burden of stroke.
How could remote monitoring help advance the standard of care for atrial fibrillation patients in the future?
Patients who have a negative Holter monitoring but have a high clinical suspicion of atrial fibrillation are probably candidates for implantable loop recorders.
How do you currently work within your setting with referring physicians pertaining to this therapy?
A field that I find very interesting is to identify patients who may have atrial fibrillation, who have never had a stroke, but who have a high risk to develop atrial fibrillation. And we have done an own small study and found that we find atrial fibrillation in 6% of hypertensive patients if we look for 1 week with an Holter monitor.
What are your perspectives on device therapy for atrial fibrillation management in the future? Where do you think this field is going?
We have to identify, or better, risk stratify the patients which need such a device. But then I think, in my opinion, this can be a tool for primary prevention in stroke. First, secondary prevention, because the numbers we need to screen are lower, and the atrial fibrillation we will find will be more frequent. And on the longer run, I hope that there will be more studies in primary prevention.